My friend, if you're struggling finding, vetting, training, and managing virtual team members for your real estate business, I have the solution for you. Call Magicians is the premier virtual assistant company in the real estate industry. And basically what they'll do is allow you to focus on closing more deals and doing the things you love while they handle the work for you. Head over to callmagicians.com and see if you're a good fit to work together. And make sure you use the promo code FLIPEMPIRE for a 20% discount off your startup fee. And by the way, the owner's a friend of mine and shares tons of value, gives a lot of useful tips on episode 540. So check it out at flipempire.com/540.
Yeah, what we try to do to begin with is, first of all, find out what our clients' goals are, what they want to accomplish. And then we talk to them about being market sensitive. Some sellers are what I call price sensitive. And those are typically the kind we can't help. You know, they got a number on it that it may or may not have anything to do with the true value of the property.
You're listening to Flip Empire, the show committed to helping real estate entrepreneurs who want to build their empire without sacrificing their life. Your success and freedom starts now with your host, Alex Pardo.
So let's start to kind of pivot into, for somebody listening, how do they even know if they should leverage an auction house, or if they you know, should use a service like yours, or even try to go about doing an auction themselves? Like, are there some key indicators or signs that you guys look for and you would say, hey, this would qualify and this is a really good exit strategy to dispose of these properties?
Yeah, what we try to do to begin with is, first of all, find out what our clients' goals are, what they want to accomplish, and then we talk to them about being market sensitive. You know, some sellers are what I call price sensitive, and those are typically the kind we can't help. You know, they got a number on it that it may or may not have anything to do with the true value of the property. So we want to talk to clients about being market sensitive, what the real value is. And if they will accept what the real market value is, then typically we can help them.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay. John, what are your thoughts? Because I know that you know, you have some experience. Jeff has been at this for many, many years on the auction side of the house, and you're kind of in our shoes as the right. real estate investor. So what's your perspective on this?
Well, my perspective is I don't know why I waited so long to remember that I was in the auction business, you know, and that it was such a great solution. One of the things that I felt was that I had a lot of clients with multiple properties, and they were moving in and out of them, in one here and one there and one closing here and one closing there. And I'm like, oh my God, if a lady has a portfolio of properties, maybe they got 30 houses, maybe they got 10, maybe they got 50, you know, and they want to move into a larger asset. How are they going to do it and do it in such a way that that they could streamline the whole process and get sold, you know, on one day? And then I said to myself, oh, the auction method, that's a great way to do this, especially if your client wants to move into a big asset like a commercial property.
Yeah.
Use a 1031 exchange, which this was perfect for the auction that we did. It met everybody's objectives, you know, and the client was very happy, you know, the way it all went down, and we sold everything on one day. So I think that for investors, this is definitely a method. I think it's in Florida, it's considered one of the methods of real estate, you know, is auction. You know, you go to a real estate school, they teach the students that, but nobody thinks to use it, you know, and it's just a great tool.